There's still more.
There's always more to do.
It's not going to be easy.
To tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die. This story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow.
He loves you.
Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
It's not safe.
Dillian.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through him before he disappears.
Dillian, don't lose him. Way too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Dillian, there he is.
Quick.
Where is he?
Where's he going?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
Does it feel warm? Do you feel safe?
Dillian loves you.
And even if I could see him, I have no weapon. Loki replies, "Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands." And Höf throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Höf is slain.
You've killed him with your love because he believed in you.
curse cannot be undone.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go. And she was caught between two worlds. That of Zindel and her past. And Dillian.
Special.
Her future.
They mean nothing.
Two realities. Tearing at her soul.
Waste of time. It could all be a waste of her time. Remember, Dillian.
The gods are just toying.
Do you remember
the sound of ears? What if the gods are laughing at her?
Messing with her.
It would be.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of Hel. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth.
Your curse has claimed Dillian. Poor Dillian. He didn't know he was kind.
Through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
You're going to fall, careful.
No, she's not. She's not going to fall. She's strong. She's steady. She can do it. You can do it, Sinra.
Understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? You give up the beautiful world thing. You, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares. Or is this the price you pay?
What if you're wrong? What if this has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be
yours. Gift that makes you so special in my life.
What if this is the end?
Just another part of the person I know.
It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before, you could be fooled again.
You're being tested. It's just their game for you.
We never know which way it's going to go.
Of course I know. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.